So hi. Yeah, let me first pick out the correct slide.
Brian, I'm putting this one here for you.
I'm guessing, isn't it? Ah, thanks. So where are we? Okay, so hi, I'm Bren Oosterbaan, almost the same, Bren Oosterbaan from SuperPhyllis. I'm a mission critical engineer and I focus mainly on storage and backup recovery, including some other stuff in our cloud and the entire stack, but mostly storage and backup recovery. And he added some cool pictures from when I was younger and way cooler, as you can see in the middle. Anyway. I'm gonna skip this because that's not much time. Anyway, so we're a mission critical outsourcing company. That means we had a lot of customers, bankers, energy trading platforms that host their applications in our data center, or our data centers actually. Usually in silos, all separate entities, but we started going to a private cloud. When we decided to go for private cloud, we started going with pods and different ZFS-based storage systems per pod. So each system has a different pod. Ah, I'm nervous as hell. Yeah, whatever. So anyway, we bought Nexendas, ZFS-based storage systems. We have 14 at the moment in different pods. Hopefully when we scale out, we'll buy more pods. If each pod has another cluster and another one and another one. So it'll grow. So no longer really big monolithic systems, but just more and more pods all the way. And with that, we had a problem. Because we figured, okay, we have these systems. We started running them, we started installing these systems. And we noticed there were some pieces missing. So one of the basic things that we need is monitoring for our systems. We use Nagios to monitor all our systems, but you can have any other system you want. And these appliances didn't come with any plugin or any tool to monitor them all. They just had their own monitoring system on there itself, and well, that was just a big issue because we need to know if something goes wrong, if a power supply fails, if there's a disk failing, all these basic things was nothing for. So we needed to fix that and write something or do something to get that information out. Second thing that we really like is advanced performance monitoring. So apart from the basics, you also want metrics. Like you just talked about with the latency. You want to know latency of disks, latency of your writes. You want to know what is this system doing. I don't like a black box appliance. I want to know what's in there. I need to get in there. Just for troubleshooting, monitoring, all kinds of stuff. And then the last thing is configuration management. If I have 14 of these systems, well, when I started setting them up, I already noticed, okay, after the basic installation, I want to change these 12 or 14 or 20 settings. I have to log into each one of them, change the settings, go to the next one, change the settings. Then after a while, you start forgetting some settings, or you need to work with a spreadsheet and checkboxes, and then you figure out later on, oh crap, this setting should actually be different, and then you have to go back and log in again. That doesn't work. And this is only with 14 appliances. I mean, what happens if you have 140 appliances? That you're going to hire someone to do this all day? That doesn't work as well. So first thing I did actually was the monitoring. What I did is I wrote a basic Nagios plugin which uses the Nexenta API, asks the runners on the Nexenta box itself what's going on. Are there any warnings, any criticals, everything, what's happening? And also statistics, just the basic statistics. So for instance, you get a warning like, okay, pool zero is degraded. Most likely because their disk has failed. Or if a disk has failed, you'll get a warning or a critical. You can configure this in a configuration file, of course. And if a JWOD power supply fails or any of that stuff, just the basics. And also really basic performance monitoring, like volume growth of a folder or a pool, snapshot growth. You can also put warnings and criticals on how full your volume is, like it's 90%, I want a critical because I need to know what's going on, or snapshot space is way too high, or stuff like that. And then within Nagios, you'll just have a quick overview of Nexendas, and you can see what's going on. And this one is really meant for Nextend itself. Some of the other stuff we've done also works on OpenSolaris or LumaOS or whatever else you like with your certified-based storage system. This one's really for Nextend. So these are just the basic settings, but the basic monitoring, but you want way better methods as well. You want to know really what's going on within your system. So for this, we used CollectD. Actually, a colleague of mine, he patched it to run on OpenIndiana, which makes it run on OpenSolaris as well. And CollectD is a really cool open source tool that you can use. You can plug in all kinds of different values, kset values, dtrace scripts, SNMP networking. It comes already with a whole host of different options and different values that it monitors. And then it throws out on the other side. And you can let it go to RDs, to CSV, or also all kinds of different options. So in our environment, we chose for graphite. So we have CollectD running on Nextend, throws all these metrics that we like to graphite. And within graphite, you can view the data, because you have this data, but you need some way to view it. And graphite is also open source, and also pretty cool, and quite powerful, actually. Because within graphite, you can create dashboards and aggregate all this information and have a really quick overview of what's happening with my system. I'll show you just a small example. So for instance, this is just a small cutout of a dashboard. Doesn't really matter what it says, but for a quick overview, CPU idle, okay. Network traffic, like you can see here that before 4, nothing was really happening with the system. Then it's between 4 and 10, someone started something, and there's 2 gigs of incoming traffic. The disks are quite busy at once, doing 200 megabytes per second, and there's about 50k, 55k of NFS operations happening. Which is easily correlated, of course, because it's very clear that these 4 things are connected. But that's just some of the things it does. It doesn't only show the data, you can manipulate the data in very handy ways. So here, for instance, we have the disks, the percent busy of the disks of that system. Well, that system has, I don't know, maybe 80 or 100 or 200 different disks. But I'm not interested about all these disks which are just doing the regular thing. I'm only interested about the outliers, like which disks are acting up, which disks are different from all the other disks. So you can choose stuff like most defiant, and it'll say, I want to see the most defiant 5. It'll show those 5 outliers, which is really what you want to see. Apart from most defiant, there's a whole load of different other settings that you can use. Different filters, scaling, percentages, non-negative derivatives, all kinds of stuff. Very cool. So just an example this is a really simple example, troubleshooting a problem that we have. There was one of the boxes was acting up. We had lots of complaints from one of our internal customers, basically my colleagues, saying, hey, my VM isn't running or whatever, it doesn't work, it's slow as hell, and basically no I/O coming through. Take a quick look at the graphs, notice immediately that there's quite high latencies. The left one is the latencies of disks, and on the right side you can see the percent busy, and apparently there's one disk between 8 and 9, for some reason is at 100% busy. That in itself doesn't have to mean that it's bad, but the system wasn't doing anything at all, so that looked quite bad. Then we looked at the spacings, the right one, that's the spacing, that's basically the flushes from the transition groups to disk. And we could see they were getting extremely delayed, like 5, 6, 7 minutes per transition group. Basically, there's no I/O going to disk at all. So something's really wrong here, and my first suspect would be that one disk that's at 100% busy. Doesn't have to be, but it points to that. But now, I need to figure out which disk is this disk within that system. If I try to open up the legend there, you can say in graphite, show me the legend, I'll see 120 disk names, and I won't be able to identify the correct one. If I do most defiant 5, it'll show me the most defiant 5 disks, and I can see the purple one is that disk number. Cool, log into the system, offline the disk, and the pool was immediately responsive again. Easy way to fix the issue. And it's just a really basic example. We've done way more cooler things as well, with bugs or features and other stuff. We can see, okay, this needs to be designed a bit different, or we need to change this a bit. And you can also do even preventive monitoring on this, because if you look at service times and stuff like that, most of the time your system won't go from I'm doing perfect to I'm doing so badly that my customers are complaining. In between, there will be a period where it slowly goes to that point. You can set events in Graphite, saying, okay, if the service times of my disk are above this or this threshold, or if these transaction groups or spacings are not going fast enough, I want an event, and then you can monitor on that event, page, or whatever. So, for monitoring and CollectD, that's really cool, but now I need to install CollectD also on my system. So I need to log in 14 times again, install CollectD, there's some configuration files that you need to change. Maybe later on I'll have some other dtrace scripts and some other configurations that I want to do as well. It'll add more and more overhead each day to whatever I'm doing. I want to do other stuff, I don't want to be bothered with all this. So, in our company, we automate everything. Like, we don't want to do any manual deployments at all. And we use OpsCout Chef for that. Really like Chef a lot. But unfortunately, there was no Chef client for Nexenda Store, or for OpenSolaris, actually. So we repackaged the Chef client to be able to run on Nexenda Store, which is, by the way, also open source Chef. And next, I created a cookbook to manage all the configuration files and all the settings that we change when we get a new system. So now, instead of doing all this manually, I get a new Nexenda, I install it, next finish. The first thing I do is still manually, unfortunately, log in and configure Chef client on the machine, install Chef client. And then just one run, two runs of Chef client itself. Takes less than a minute. And all the settings I want to change are changed. All the name server settings, all the NFS specific settings or ZFS specific settings, and syslog, time servers, anything you can think of, it's all done. Installation of CollectD is done as well. It's all automatic. And then after that, every 15 minutes, it'll check back with the Chef server. It'll ask the Chef server, okay, is there anything else you need me to do? Chef itself will check all these configuration files, check if they are still the way they should be. If they are, it doesn't do anything. If they're changed, it'll change them back. Or if the recipe has been changed, the cookbook has been changed, it'll change those settings. So now if I want to change some setting at all in the system file, for instance, I'll change that setting in the cookbook itself, and 15 minutes later, all my Nexendas have been updated, all the settings have been set. And that's all. That makes it really, really easy to do. One last thing. So it's 97% Illuminus and Open Indiana compatible. There are one or two settings there which are Nexenda specific, but you can use it for all these other ZFS storage systems as well. It sets, like I said, log RDM, NFS settings, and time server, SNP, everything I want to set. It doesn't set other settings which you guys have need, for instance. Please let me know, I'd like to add all this stuff. It's all open source. Actually, all the stuff I just talked about is open source. Graphite is open source, CollectD. The cookbook I created is on, you can just download it from GitHub. The monitoring, the Nagios monitoring, you can download from GitHub. That's it.